Today I'm going to talk to you about these bad boys. These are pressure reducing valves. Now in newer houses, new builds, i.e. 10 to 12 years or younger, you tend to find the water pressure in these houses is excessively high. Now all you need in your house is around about 3 bar. I have seen anything up to about 9 bar in houses, which is enormous amounts of pressure. If you turned a tap on, you'd probably hit the back of your house quite easily with it. Now, pressure's great. We like a lot of pressure in our taps. It means water comes out nice and fast. However, having too much pressure can cause problems. It puts unnecessary stress on joints, on taps, on washers, and just on the pipework in general. In a lot of times, the pipework and joints aren't actually supposed to be taking those huge amounts of pressure. What you tend to find in a new build is up in the airing cupboard, you will actually have a pressure reducing valve. However, because the stopcock is down in somewhere like the kitchen, airing cupboards upstairs, you tend to find downstairs taps, kitchen taps, downstairs toilet taps, and even outside garden taps aren't actually covered by the pressure reducing valve that is all the way up in the airing cupboard. So best advice is actually to put these straight on after the mains. That way you can actually have your whole house covered by that reduced pressure. 3 bar is more than enough and is actually the maximum we tend to say you should need in your house. Just turning stopcocks down, which is what a lot of people tend to think is a good thing to do, doesn't actually reduce pressure. There's two kinds of pressure. There's working pressure, there's standing pressure. Working pressure is just what's coming out of your taps as it's running. As soon as you turn your tap off, the pressure that's coming into your house slowly builds and builds and builds to a point where we then have a standing pressure because that water's not moving. Just turning a stopcock down or a tap down or something like that coming into your house doesn't reduce that standing pressure. It just reduces the rate at which it builds up. What we actually need to do is reduce that standing pressure and the working pressure to a manageable level. So if you'd like to know more about how to reduce your pressure or know more about what we can do to fit these for you, give us a call or an email. Happy to talk.